I have a sample SLR5500 code plug in front of me, and I have the latest CPS, and the firmware in the repeater is on the latest. And I want to talk to you about a relatively new feature in the repeaters that allows you to avoid having to use a static IP address in the master repeater. And this feature is known as DNS. Now, if you go to the repeater code plug and you go into network and you scroll right down the bottom, you will see that there is an entry here for DNS addresses. So here we would put in the name of the DNS server that we are using on our network. So I'm going to put in a DNS address here, and it's a real server name. So I'm just going to put some arbitrary value in here. So this would be the name of the DNS server, the address, internet address, if you want to call it that, of the DNS server. So the master repeater and the peer repeaters will use this DNS server to get information about the master repeater IP address. The next thing that you want to do here is you want to set up DHCP. Now, if you look at this repeater, you'll see that this field is grayed out. The reason for this is if you go to link establishment, you have to set the link type to be either master or peer. So I'm going to set this one up as the master repeater. And if we go back to network here, you will see that all of these fields are now grayed, ungrayed. So even though this is the master repeater, I'm going to tick DHCP. And what that means is, although this is the master repeater, it's going to be using DHCP to get its IP address. The other thing that it will do is, as part of the, let's say, the connection setup procedure, as part of this DHCP process, it will also get the IP address of the DNS server, or DNS servers, and this will come from the DHCP server. This is standard networking. The next thing that you want to do is you want to come here to link establishment, and you will see that we've set this repeater up to be the master repeater. There is a field here to enter the master IP address. We don't really need this because we are using DNS, so we put a tick here for DNS. Because we're using DNS, we don't have to put an IP address in, but we have to specify the address of the DNS server. So we select DNS, this DNS address, and that's this address that I specified over here. So we select the master DNS address, and when the master connects to the network, it will contact the DNS server, and it will tell the DNS server, hey, I'm here and I'm at this IP address, so that when the peers also connect, they will go to the DNS server, and the DNS server will also tell them what is the IP address of the master repeater. Now, when it comes to capacity plus single site and multi-site, we have this IP address, the REST channel / site IP, and this address needs to be static, but we don't need to worry about it, because in capacity plus multi-site, this IP address will not be routed out onto the WAN, so it will stay only on that site for, let's say, inter-site or intra-site communication. So the repeaters talking to each other on the same capacity plus multi-site RF site. So that's what's required for setting up DNS in the motor turbo repeaters. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.